it's Hadar. Welcome to my channel. Today we are going to tackle confusions around spelling versus pronunciation. Sometimes you may look at a word and it looks exactly like another word that is spelled the same, but they sound completely different to you. Or sometimes you see two words that are completely different, yet they sound exactly the same. And then you think to yourself, how is that even possible? Well, it's possible. Because you know why? It's English. And anything happens in English, especially when it's related to spelling and pronunciation. So English is not a phonetic language, therefore the spelling does not represent the pronunciation of a sound or a word. So what we're going to do today is we're going to tackle the places where it clashes in your brain, like where you get confused, and that happens usually either when it comes to homophones or heterographs, and that is when words are spelled differently but pronounced the same, like flower versus flower. And in the next lesson, because it's a two-part video series, we're going to talk about homographs. That means the words are spelled the same but pronounced differently, like tear versus tear, right? So what's going to happen is that we're going to cover a bunch of pairs that are very commonly used, and we want to make sure that we clear all confusion around them. So let's begin with part one, words that are spelled differently but pronounced the same. The first one is flower. Both are pronounced exactly the same. Fla-wer. You move from the W to the R. Wer. Flower. It's both for, oh, what a beautiful flower, or this cake doesn't have any flour in it. Flower. Then we have here. It's an H sound, then a high E. He, and then you shift to the R. Here. Make sure the E is long enough. Here. It's both for I can hear you pretty well and I'm right here. Here. Then we have sun. It's an S sound, a cup, it's like a stressed schwa, and an N sound. Sun. Make sure you lift the tip of the tongue to touch the upper palate for the N. Sun. Sun. And it's both for the sun in the sky or my son doesn't like to wake up in the morning. Next up, there. These three words are homophones, pronounced exactly the same. A TH sound, th, then an E, so drop your jaw a little bit, there, and then at the end you bring the tongue up for the R. There. There. All three words are pronounced the same. It's over there. It's their house. They're pretty satisfied about it. They're pretty satisfied about it. There they are. They're pretty satisfied about it. This is a contraction. And by the way, I have a full video about contractions that you can watch. I'm going to put a link in the show notes for it. There. Right and right. I actually get a lot of questions about this pair. And people ask me how to pronounce the right, right? I need to write a book in comparison to my right arm, right? So here they're pronounced exactly the same. It's an R sound. You don't really hear the W when it's before an R. It doesn't really exist. Right, so round your lips for the R, change it to an I as in my, right, and bring the tongue up for a T sound at the end, right. You can release the T, right, very lightly, or hold it, right, for a held T. Just stop the breath abruptly or stop the sound, right, and that's the T, right. I need to write a book or write an article, and it's on your right. Road versus road. As you can see, they're pronounced the same. Another R word, round your lips, then it's the O as in go, road. And finish it up with a D. I'm on the road and I rode my bike yesterday. Road. Then we have this one, horse. Horse. So here we start with an H sound, then the OR as in four. Horse. Make sure you pronounce the H. Horse. I'm sure you know the meaning of the first one, horse, like I rode my horse yesterday in the farm. So I don't just ride my bike, I also ride horses. Horse. The other one means that I strain my voice. My voice gets all raspy and tired. It's when you have a cold and your voice gets hoarse. Hoarse, okay? So I spoke all day yesterday in a meeting and now my voice is hoarse. They're pronounced exactly the same. It's kind of funny. Soul. Soul. I'm the sole owner of the company. Soul. Or you have a beautiful soul. Soul. Here we start with an S sound, then it's the O as in go, so, and a dark L at the end. Soul. So you have that back, dark, deep voice quality, sound quality to it. Soul. The next one, war. These two words are also pronounced the same. War. Here you start with the W sound, then again we have the or as in four. War. Make sure you drop the tongue after the W so it doesn't sound like were, right? War. War. So the first meaning is war, as in make love, not war. And the second one is the past form of the word wear, the verb wear, to wear something. So I wore this sweater last night as well, or I wore it out completely. War. Sea. I see the sea. Sea, as in the verb, and sea is where you go to get in the water. See. It's an S sound and high E. Make sure it's long, so it's not see, see. 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 And the last one for today is 2, 2, and 2. So we have the number 2. I need 2 people to help me. 2. It's a T sound, then the long OO sound. And you want to imagine if you're adding a W at the end. 2. Also, the word 2 as in as well. I need 2 people too. 2, pronounced exactly the same. Then we have 2, as in to go. But you already know, because you've been following my videos, that the word 2 is usually reduced to to go. However, when it's at the end of the word, or when the word is stressed, it is pronounced like the number 2. 2. I don't know where I need to go to. 2. 2, right? I don't know where I need to go to. If the 2 is at the end, it is not going to be reduced. Listen, I don't know where I need to go to. I mean, no, okay? So you want to pronounce it fully like the number 2. That's when it's a homophone. That's when it's pronounced the same. But other than that, it can be dropped to T and then it doesn't sound the same. Okay. Okay, that's it. Now, let me know what other homophones are you familiar with. Again, homophones are words that are written differently or spelled differently, but pronounced exactly the same. Put them in the comments below and let's all practice together and see if you got them right. Don't forget to tune in next week, because next week I'm going to talk about words that are spelled the same but pronounced differently. And this might be even more challenging because you might not even know that they're pronounced differently. So we want to tackle that confusion as well. So make sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel or to my newsletter to get this lesson into your inbox and other fun stuff every single week. So that's it. So I'm waiting to hear from you in the comments, and like this video and share it if you liked it. And I will see you in the second part next week. Bye.